Hi, everybody, and welcome to the morning line from Keeneland Racecourse, where the weather continues to keep us guessing out here in Lexington. It was 75 and sunny yesterday. That has made way to overcast skies, temperatures in the low 40s. The wind is picking up as well, but the main track is fast. The turf course is rated as good, and the racing is always good when you're out here at Keeneland Racecourse. We'll talk about the races coming up in a little bit. Before we do that, I want to let you know about an event coming up later tonight. It is hosted by our very own Caton Bredar at Castleton Lions. It is the Dr. Tony Ryan Book Award, an award given to a book published from the previous year with horse racing as the central theme. With the three finalists is Caton right now. She's down on the winner's circle.
I don't know if everyone knows, but I am a true bookworm. If there's something I love as much as horse racing, it's reading. And this year we had three outstanding books about horse racing, all three fiction. And I am so happy to be joined by the authors of the three finalists for tonight's competition. Sasscer Hill, the author of Flamingo Road. Heather Henson, who's The Whole Sky, is in the adult or young adult fiction category. And Felix Francis, the author of Pulse, a Dick Francis novel. And welcome to all of you. I think it's remarkable that this year we have three works of fiction, but such enjoyable and thoroughly great reads where you learn something about horse racing or some element in each and every one of them, which for me is an exceptional accomplishment. Also, all three involving female main characters. So we really stepped things up this year in terms of the diversity in the competition as well. Felix, I have to admit that I'm a little starstruck as I really enjoyed all the works of your father, Dick Francis, and you ably carrying on that tradition in the real spirit of his work. Tell me a little about Pulse and what inspired you, and are you a little surprised to be here today among the finalists?
Well, Pulse is, as you say, for the first time in 51 books that have got a female protagonist, and it's written in the first person. So I wrote it as a female, so that was quite a change. Yes, it's lovely to be here back at Keeneland, and very exciting to be one of the three finalists. Looking forward to tonight. Pulse is set in England, and it's steeplechasing, and my main character is a doctor, emergency medicine doctor, and the racing is important, but it's more what else is going on around it. I mean, she works in the local emergency room, someone turns up, a man is brought in from the race course and ends up dead, and she herself has medical problems in terms of an eating disorder and depression, and she's fairly obsessive, and she becomes very obsessed with who the man is, because there's no way of telling who he is. He has no ID, and the police can't find out who he is. So she becomes very obsessed with who he is and how he died and why he died. And the more she digs, the more trouble she gets into.
And the better the book gets as well. And I would add as much information and a real sensitive and thorough approach to the issues of mental illness to go along with the horse racing theme in that book. And Heather, the Whole Sky really touches, in addition to the mare reproductive loss syndrome that hit Kentucky and inspired by some of those true events, as well on some of the plights and trials and tribulations of a young girl, horse crazy, kind of growing up and coming of age, dealing with some incredible loss in her family. Kind of a thorough look at the breeding industry as well. You had to have done a lot of research for this.
I did. I did a lot of research, and I was really touched. You know, it was 2001 when MRLS came to fore, and over 500 thoroughbred foals died that foaling season or were stillborn. And I was really moved by that. I'm actually from Kentucky, born and raised, but I lived in New York for many years, and there were articles about that in the New York Times, and I became very fascinated and started doing research, and was interested in how the researchers at UK were really working around the clock to try to find what was happening. Also moved by the accounts of people who were losing the foals or stillborn. It was just you know, heartbreaking. So I was really inspired to write about that. I always tend to write in my book, in my children's books, a strong female protagonist. And so that's definitely her. She's dealing with a lot. Her mother has died. Her father started to drink. I'm also someone who believes that children's books, you don't write down to kids. They can deal with a lot. They want to see themselves in the books and see what is happening in their lives. And so I think it's important to write about tough issues.
It's a fine line between adult and young adult fiction, but I would say a line that you walk beautifully and a wonderful read. One of the favorites, right along with Sasser's work, which, Sasser, I've followed your work all along. I think I've read everything that you've written, and you have been a finalist before and down this road. But this book, I thought, kind of brought everything together with a brand new heroine at the center of this, but the usual exciting twists and turns involved with some very important themes.
Yes. The book has two major threads that run through it that is involved with the criminals. And one is dimorphin, which was a drug that was first found out in Oklahoma at Remington Park. And the other thing that is a true thing that I put into the book are these Cuban Americans in the C9 Basin that are slaughtering horses for the black market horse meat. And I thought, wow, those two things are just both incredible. So I drew them both into the story with Fia, who had gotten involved, unfortunately, and she'd had to shoot a man and kill him. And she was suspended from the Baltimore Police Department, where she was a cop. And luckily for her, she was made an offer that she could not refuse. She was told, we can get you a position with the Thoroughbred Racing Protective Bureau because they happen to need somebody like you right now, or you can just leave. So, you know, obviously she went and worked for the Thoroughbred Racing Protective Bureau, which has been fun because I really enjoyed meeting the president and vice president up there and learning a lot about the bureau. I brought all those threads together and it made for a really good story, and I enjoyed writing it.
An exceptional story and a finalist again in the Dr. Tony Ryan Castleton Lyons Book Contest. Joaquin, all three exceptional winning reads in my book, and the winner will be announced this evening with a $10,000 prize. It's one of the richest prizes that's awarded in this country for any type of book. And hats off to Castleton Lyons for continuing to support literature and horse racing. Tremendous event. And again, a real thrill to be with all three of our authors today.
All right, Caton, thank you very much, and good luck to those three finalists later this evening at Castleton Lyons. Caton did give me the books up here on the desk. This is The Whole Sky. That is by Heather Henson. As Caton was mentioning, Felix Francis, the son of Dick Francis. This is the book Pulse. And then the last finalist this evening is by Sasscer Hill. That is Flamingo Road. Caton was telling me it started with right around 20 books. It has been all the way down, or knocked down all the way down to three finalists. As she was mentioning, a $10,000 prize on the line. So congratulations to those finalists of making it this far, and good luck to them tonight taking down that $10,000 prize coming up later this evening from Castleton Lyons. We'll step away for a short time out here on the morning line. When we return, we'll start talking about the 9-race program that we have coming up from Keeneland Racecourse.